been a massive day today, as you can understand. As you were told earlier on, we had an arts festival. The arts festival wouldn't have gone ahead without our many volunteers. We had over 68 volunteers, which I am so grateful to every one of them. And without our sponsors today, we wouldn't have been able to put on our event, especially out in the courtyard. So there's been various other sponsors throughout the day that have contributed, but I particularly want to thank the councillor donation system. Without that, we wouldn't have been able to have our stage outside. So basically, from those of you that weren't here today, from 9 o'clock this morning to 5 o'clock this evening, we've had live entertainment from each one of our members of the Alliance. So the Alliance have 30 members, and most of them are represented here today. And I just look at how much work has gone into today's proceedings. And as you were told, it took 12 months of organisation, many grants that we applied for, but unfortunately we weren't successful. But that's why it was so important that the councillors managed to give their grant donation, so that was so important to us. But just in the planning, various meetings went ahead. And when I stood back and looked, I thought, well, we have put on this one event. Our members, we have choirs, we have theatres, we have orchestras, and they put on many events each year. And they do keep going, and they continue to keep going. But I thought, well, they have lots of volunteers too. And when I looked at the volunteers, I realised that some of those volunteers are not just volunteers because they want to be one. There's sometimes stories behind the reason why they're volunteers. And I know that some people are involved with the arts for many different reasons, whether that they've lost a loved one and they want to occupy their time because it gets a bit lonely at night time, whether there's children out there that are doing it because they love performing. I know myself, my personal battle was, I was dyslexic at school, and they actually said to me, have you tried performing? It helps you with your dyslexia by reading scripts and learning things like that. So behind what I'm trying to say to you all is, what you see on the stage is a very small percentage of what goes on. And there's personal reasons why people are involved with theatre, and there's various different reasons why they are. But if you look beyond the performance you see, there's a lot more involved. I know that one of our members of the Alliance, they actually rehearse in a pig shed. Now, when you go and actually see their show, you have got no idea that they were rehearsing in a pig shed. Now, I think that's good that they actually clean their shoes before they go on stage. I know there is another member of our Alliance family, he's a teacher, and he gets a group of teenage children, high school children, to perform, write their own songs, sing their own songs, write their own scripts, and that alone is just amazing. So I just like to say, I think what I'm trying to say is there's a lot involved with theatre other than what you see. And through people like yourselves that are supporting theatre, hopefully the Alliance family can continue. Times are tough out there, so I'd just like to just ask you just to maybe support each other a little bit more and just support each other in what you do. And if you're a parent that's here to see your daughter or son on stage this evening, please come back. Please come back and support your local family theatre. There's a lot of enjoyment involved in theatre. And I like to think that it's theatre is the TV you can touch. TV at home is great, but it's not that good. You can't get involved. I know that I've been to very many shows this year. I've sat there, and some of the shows I'm not familiar with. And if it's a thriller, I've been really disappointed to find out the guy that I thought had killed them wasn't the right one. I thought it was quite frustrating. I've had my sides split from laughter. I was actually moved to tears almost when I went to see the Philharmonic or Youth Orchestra, because my mum's wish is to actually go to the London last night at the Proms, and they played Land of Hope and Glory, and I was like, oh my God, I wish my mum was here. So the music and the performance doesn't just what you see. It can mean many personal things to many people. And as you saw before we started today, all the lineup that we've got coming in the next 12 months, it's amazing. I'd like to commend all our members. And through the Gold Coast Theatre Alliance, there's over 104,000 tickets available each year to live performances, which I think is amazing. So from behalf of me, I'd like to thank all our members for all the work they do. So congratulations to you all. I hope you enjoy the rest of the proceedings this evening. If you've been a volunteer and I haven't shook your hand, I'm sorry. Come and see me after, because I want to thank you. Please enjoy the evening. I hope you join us later on for a bit of a supper. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Matt Randle.
Before you go, I've always wanted to do this. They're all doing it on TV. Can we do a giant selfie?
Smile, everyone, you're on camera.
Oh, that's lovely.
Take it off! Sorry, we rehearsed this one.
It's been rehearsed. Smile, everyone. Smiles. Yeah. There you go. This is Matt Randle, president of the Gold Coast Theatre Alliance. Great message, Clark. Thank you, Matt. Well, folks, following that, our next entertainer for us this evening is somebody I'm familiar with, most of you will be familiar with, the Gold Coast soprano, Deborah Leigh Russell. A passion for the creative arts, and has performed from the classical and opera to jazz and popular musical theatre. Tonight, she gives us a sample of her versatility, singing an Andrew Lloyd Webber classic and an opera piece by Puccini. Would you please give a big welcome to the stage, Deborah Leigh Russell.
Love changes everything.
Portugalis from opera, and it's Omil Babino Carlo from the opera Gianni Schicchi by Puccini. Very passionate little number where the young girl is begging her father, "Oh, daddy, daddy, my beautiful daddy, my beloved papa, please let me go and get the ring. Otherwise, I'll from the boy that I love. Otherwise, I'll just throw myself off the river Arno." And that is actually what she is singing. Thank you.
Please thank Deborah Leigh Russell. Thank you, Deborah.